This case study was inspired by the following Reddit post, which happens to be the top post of all time. We will be discussing how we can create this hand grip pattern. The main challenge here is to have the pattern follow the curvature of the surface. If you wish to follow along, I have provided a link to download the stock body. Let's create the seat or starting feature. I have prepared a circle sketch. Do note that this sketch was created on a 45 degree plane between the top plane and the right plane. The first method that came to my mind was to create an extrude based off the curved surface. Start the extrude command. Select the circle as a profile. Go to Extend Type and choose Tool Object. Select this face as the object. The extrude would take this face as a reference to control the extent. Set the operation to Join and adjust the offset. This creates a protrusion that leverages on the existing curved surface. The top face of the cylinder is an offset of the underlying face. If you select this face and right-click, notice that there is no option to create a sketch. This shows that it is indeed a curved face. Now that we have the seat feature, let's try to create a row of these along the length of the body as a test. Let's try to do a rectangular pattern. Would the pattern feature be intelligent enough to vary the extrude extent as we move across this surface? Let's find out. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. For Type, select Features and select the extrude. For Directions, click on the select box and select the Z-axis in this case. Adjust the distance and quantity. For Compute option, we will need to choose Adjust. This will ensure that every subsequent pattern feature will take reference from the underlying face and adjust the extent accordingly. When we confirm the feature, for some reason, the pattern stops halfway. The only positive thing is that the pattern features are taking reference from the underlying surface. Let's go back into the extrude for the seat feature. So it seems like the pattern features are not following this face. Instead of selecting a face as a reference, let's try selecting a body. Remove the existing selection. If you try to select the body from the Bodies folder, you will find that the extrude points downwards. Let's remove the selection. Instead, look for a location on this side, and once you are roughly in line with the sketch circle, hover the cursor over this tangent edge until you see the whole body being highlighted, and click to select. This points the extrude in the correct direction. Once you confirm the extrude and let the rectangular pattern regenerate, you can see that we have obtained the result that we need. So I did this first row as an experiment to see if a rectangular pattern would work. Let's remove that. The final result actually calls for a staggered pattern. Let's go inside the circle sketch. And draw a 45 degree line from the center. Make this construction. Mirror this across the horizontal. These two construction lines will serve as directions for the rectangular pattern. At this point, I would advise you to save. Begin the rectangular pattern. Change the type to features and select the extrude. For directions, click on the select box and select the two construction lines. change the distance type to spacing. For both direction type, choose one direction. Adjust the quantity and distance. For compute option, select Adjust. Once you confirm, it might take a while for the feature to compute. If it takes too long or even crashes, I would advise you to try again by reducing the quantity. So obviously, this is not what we want. How do we get to this point? We have the option of going back into the pattern feature and suppressing the unwanted instances. However, there is no easy way to uncheck all these boxes. Perhaps we can devise some way of cutting away the excess. Neither of these methods are ideal. Fortunately, there is a much better way to do this. And this is actually related to a pattern masking video that I did earlier. The pattern is restricted to a region that can be defined in the shape of a slot. I prepared a sketch for this. Let's roll the timeline back to before the seed extrude feature. We are going to use this slot sketch to perform a split body. This will isolate the region that we need. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the whole body as a body to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Let's roll the timeline forward and give the feature some time to regenerate. It seems pretty amazing that by just splitting the body, the features have regenerated and given us exactly what we need. We did not even have to go into the extrude or the pattern features to make any adjustments. So what is happening here? Let's go back into the extrude for the seed feature. Remember previously that we had selected the whole body as a reference to control the extrude extent. Looking at the body highlighted in blue, you can see that the extrude has adjusted accordingly and chosen a split body as the reference object. So what about a rectangular pattern? Why does a pattern not exceed the boundaries of the split body? With the extrude now taking reference from this new split body, the pattern command would also respect that. Every single pattern feature would take reference only from the split body. The instances outside of the boundary has no reference and would thus be ignored. A word of caution here. I have done this multiple times and in some cases, the extrude does not choose the correct body. If you do experience this, you will need to go back into the extrude. Remove the selected object. As before, do not select the body from the bodies folder. Rather, hover the cursor over the tangent edge at roughly this location until you see the split body being highlighted and make the selection. After you confirm, the pattern should regenerate correctly. Hope that you have found this useful. I am thinking about making a full-length video to show how the whole handle is made depending on the response to this video. So let's target 500 likes. Thank you for the support.